So, good evening, dear students. Class 10. So, quadratic equation chapter completed. The next chapter is arithmetic progression. So, arithmetic progression is a real life oriented chapter. Its a shortcut is AP. Okay, AP arithmetic progression. There are only 3 to 4 formulas only, but it's a real oriented. For example, I'll start with this example. 2, 4, 6, -10. What may be the next term? So first of all, you will check the pattern, okay? So the difference would be, this difference between these two terms is 2, and this is 2. So the next term, confirm the next term will be 8. So difference is same. Similarly, 3, 6, -9, -15. Surely you'll be telling that 12. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, etc., 5. The next term will be 4. Clear? So you'll be checking that. You'll be checking the difference between the first, these two terms. So first of all, what are the numbers of all this? First term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term. Similarly, here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms. 5 terms. So similarly, I'm going to give you one more example. 10, 20, -30, -60. So confirm, you'll check first term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term, or sixth term. So first, what's the difference between first two terms? 10. Second and third term difference, 10. For sure, the number will be, next term will be 40, the next term will be 50. So in AP chapter, first of all, meaning of the chapter is arithmetic progression. Progression, it's a continuous process. Continuous process, change, okay? And arithmetic is based on number. So the change based on number is called as arithmetic progression. Suppose I'm giving you in this first one sequence, okay? So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. What may be the 100th term? What may be the, for example, if I ask you the next term, I will be telling that 12. If I ask you next term, I will be telling 18. If I ask you next term, 6. If I ask you next term, 70. But if I ask you what may be the 100th term, what may be the 20th term, what may be the 15th term, what this is the first part of an arithmetic progression. Second part, sum of the arithmetic. For example, sum, what is going to be sum? Addition. So if you add this one, 5 terms, okay? If I add these 5 terms, 18, 24, 28, 30. If you add this, 27, 36, 40, 43. If you add this one, 9, 12, 14, 15. If you add this one, 110, 150, 180, 200, 210. Suppose I'm asking you to add 100 terms, if you add, what is the answer? 20 terms, if you add, what is the answer? So that is said to be sum of n terms, sum of terms. This is said to be number of terms, and that's said to be sum of terms. So there are three exercises. There are three exercises. The three exercises are very easy. The only thing is you have to understand the logic behind the each sum. Then you can do on your own. Okay. So let me introduce a chapter with a small example. Then you can have an idea based on this. So for example, I'm asking that I will enter the past 12 classes and asking the students how many of them got below 80 marks. Huh? There were many students will be standing there. So I can count, okay, like for example, 10 students are standing, na? Total number of terms is 10. Then, for example, I'll write, okay, so I'm entering into the classroom, 12B section I'm entering. I'm asking how many of them got below 40. So there will be 10 students are standing there. So what are the marks I'm asking? So they're asking, they're telling that sir, my mark is 10, 12, 15, 18, 30, and one is turning 40, and 17, 16, 13, 3, 6, 9, and 1 is telling 9 marks. So below 40 they are standing. So how many terms are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there are 10 terms are there. Okay, number of terms is 10. So whether it forms AP or not. So AP is said continuous change. So continuous change, huh? The difference between the number must be same. So now I'll arrange in the ascending order. 9, 10, 12, 15, 18, maybe 16, somebody will come here, next term 18, next is 13 also will come here, 9, 10, 12, 13, 15, 16, 17, 18, and the next one is 30, next one is 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, whether it forms a AP or not, whether the difference is same or not, the difference between these two terms, 1, difference between these two terms, 2, difference between these two terms, 1, difference between these two, 2. So there is no continuous process. So the difference is not same. Nah. this is said to be not an AP. If the difference is same, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, continuously the difference is 2 na, this is said to be AP. So you have to be very clear that if the difference are same na, that is said to be AP. If the difference are not same na, that is not an AP. Okay, this is a small introduction about the chapter. But in progression, difference must be same. Okay, so now I'll move on. What are the formulas involved in that? How to use the formulas? So first instruction is AN formula. For example, A n equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Okay, so A n, nth term, A n na, nth term or last term, whichever is easy to your mind you can keep, nth term or last term. A na, first term, n, number of terms, total number of terms, D, common difference. Common difference. I repeat again. A n na nth term, A na first term. For example, I'll take one small example. 5, 10, 15, 20. Okay, and 25. Now, A n, what's the last term? 25 is equal to, what is A? First term, 5 plus number of terms. Suppose I doesn't know the number of terms. Only 5 terms are given. I can substitute directly 5. Suppose I don't know how many terms. Now, keep it as n minus 1 into D. D, what is the D? Difference. Difference between each term, it must be same. So difference between second term and first term. So A2 na, A suffix 2, second term, A1 first term. So difference 10 minus 5. So D equal to 5. So 5. Next 25 plus 5 comes this way na, minus 5. So N minus 1 into 5. The next is 20 equal to N minus 1 into 5. So 20 upon 5 equal to n minus 1. So 5 equal to n minus 1. So 5, so see I have to 4. So 4 equal to n minus 1. So n equal to 5. So I have 5 terms in this series. This is how you have to find out number of terms. But this is second exercise. Okay. But the introduction is an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. An na nth term, a na first term, n na number of terms, d na common difference. Difference how to find out? A2 minus a1. What is a2? Second term, a1 first term. So you can ask me, sir, can I find, for example, 5, 10, 13, sir? How come it forms AP? No, it's not AP. AP na a2 minus a1, 5. a3 minus a2, 5. a4 minus a3, 5. a5 minus a4, this must be 5. So the difference must be same. This is said to be AP. Okay. So one more thing I read. So in the first exercise or second exercise, AN formula. Next, difference. Difference na second term minus first term. So A3 minus A2 or whatever it is, it must be same. Okay. Next is shortcut. So for example, I need to shortcut. What are the shortcuts? So first term na A1, second term na A2, okay, 100th term. So suppose if n equal to 1, what may be the answer? N equal to 1, wherever n comes 1 potina, so A plus 1 minus 1 into D, so I got A. A2, wherever n comes put 2, so A plus 2 minus 1 into D, so A plus 1D. So second term, A2 na A plus 1D, so third term na A plus 2D. Upper 10th term na A plus 9D. Upper 100th term na A plus 99D. Suppose 30th term A30 na A plus 29D. Okay, 9th term A9. Upper na A plus 8D. 7th term A7. Upper na A plus 6D. 15th term, A15, apala A plus 14D. Like this, you have to shortcut. So I repeat again, 16th term, apala A plus 15D. 1 must be reduced. After 25th term, A25, apala A plus 24D. So year after, you should be very clear that 10th term, na A plus 9D. 11th term, na A plus 10D. 9th term, abina, or immediately you should mind go on. 9th term, A99, abina, A plus 99D. How it came? Wherever n comes, I put 99. So A plus 90, 81 should be reduced. After the A, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24, 24 This can be A3 minus A2, A4 minus A3. And next one, you have to move on to the next one is shortcut. A 10th term. 10th term na unit you minus should go on. A 10 abina A plus 90. 8th term. A 8 abina A plus 70. Next one on the 6th term. A 6 abina A plus 5D. Like this it goes on. Clear? Any doubt? So they will ask you based on this formula. They will ask you how many terms are there. Immediately you have to use this formula. Find the first term. If the last term is given, n is given, d is given. Use this formula. Find the difference. If last term and first term n is given, use this formula. Find the last term. Find the nth term. If first term is given, number of terms is given, and d is given. Everything for you have to use this formula. So this is a n formula introduction. Next, I move on to the sum of n terms formula introduction. So this video fully introduction of the AP chapter. So what is sum of n terms? Sum of n terms can be written as Sn, sum of Sn. So there are two formulas, Sn equal to n upon 2 times 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This is one formula. And the second formula is Sn equal to n by n upon 2 into a plus l, a plus l. Sn, now introduction I will give you. Sn, sum of, so Sn are sum of n terms and n. N na number of terms. Like this, you have to write in your classwork. A na, as I said earlier, first term. D na, what I told you, difference. Similarly, Sn, I told you Sn has two formulas. Similarly, Sn, sum of N terms. N, number of terms. A, first term. L abdina, last term. There are two formulas you can use it. You have to know which formula you have to use for which sum. So, sum of two terms, apana S2. Sum of 10 terms, upper S10 they are asking you, wherever n comes you have to put 10. Find the sum of 15 terms, wherever n comes you have to 15. Upper 15 by 2, 2a plus n minus 1, n 15 into d. D not difference, difference ka formula, same formula. So how to find the difference? A2 minus a1, okay, second term minus first term. Similarly, so sum of, for example, find the 10th term, find the sum of 10th term. So find the 10th term. For example, 10 students, 5 students are standing. Okay. Imagine 5 students are standing. I was asked to find out what is the 5th term, what is the sum of 5 terms. 5th term na, they are asking you A5. A5 na, A plus 4D. Clear? 5th term, 5th person. Sum of 5 terms, they are asking you S5, wherever n comes I have to substitute 5. Clear? There is a difference between find the 5th term, find the sum of 5th term. Similarly, sum of 2 terms, they won't ask you sum of 1 term because there is no valid English word. Find the sum of, it must be 2 terms, it must be 3 terms, it must be 4 terms, it must be 10 terms. There should not be sum of one term. So sum of one term meaning in a, they are indirectly they're telling you the first term is sum of one term. Okay. So sum of two terms. Okay. So you have to be very clear. Please be understand. You repeat one more time. Sum of n term. Sn equal to n upon 2 2a. Same. Sn na sum of n terms. N na number of terms. Another formula to find the Sn. N by 2 into a plus l. Clear? Any doubt? Please. You can ask me in the online classes also. Next. Third introduction is general term for the AP, arithmetic progression. There is one more formula is there that I will teach you later in the next video. What is the general term? General term for the AP. So general term, abina, first term is called as A1 or A. Second term, A2, A3, A4, A5. First term A. Second term shortcut, A2 and another A plus 1D. Third term shortcut, A plus 2D. Fourth term, A plus 3D. Fifth term, A plus 4D. Suppose if I ask you to go back, okay, what is the before term? So here a plus 1d a, before that na a minus 1d, 11th question. Next one, a minus 2d. So this arithmetic progression is used in the class 11 sequence and series chapter, and class 12 also GP, AP. So be very careful. So the general term for the AP is this one, a comma, you can write the first 5 terms also, no problem. A comma, a plus 1d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d. If you want to go back, a minus 1d, a minus 2d, okay, they will ask you, sum of 3 terms is 20. Find sum of 3 terms, a plus 1d plus a plus 2d equal to 20. So, 3a plus 3d equal to 20, like this way, general term you have to use it. So, this is a general term, a comma, a plus 1d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, a plus 4d, shortcut I have written here. Any other? So, a n formula are given, what is the use of a n formula, where we have to use, how many terms, find the number of terms, which term, find the difference, to find the number of terms, n, everything you have to use a n formula. And SN formula, find the sum of n terms, sum of 15 terms, sum of 20 terms, and general term, a plus 1d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, a plus 4d, difference, a2 minus a1, shortcut, 100th term, a 100 na a plus 99d, 20th term, a 20 na a plus 19d, 15th term, a 15 equal to a plus 14d, 11th term, a plus 10d, like this you have to use. So there are one more. Sn minus Sn minus 1. You can note it down somewhere. So An equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. This one you can note it down somewhere. This one I can clarify later. Okay. An equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. So mostly word problems here also will be coming, but the real life oriented chapter, very easiest chapter. Okay. So next video I'll start with the exercise examples and exercise.